we've got what should be an intriguing matchup between the Cleveland Browns and the Pittsburgh Steelers. So with that, let's get you up to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. Standing by for the call, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, we are at the confluence of the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Cleveland Browns. Brandon Godden, Charles Davis, happy to be with you. And Charles, we've got two teams who know each other extremely well. These division games, they tend to be battles.
People scout like crazy in this league, but no one scouts more than within the division. Because if you win your division, you're automatically in the playoffs. That puts extra emphasis on these games, and they can't wait to get at each other.
Here we go from Heinz Field as Chris Boswell tees it up and boots it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. Under center, it's the 2017 Heisman Trophy winner as you get a look at Baker Mayfield. First play, second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. A toss play to Chubb. Space to maneuver at the 40. And all the way up to the 45-yard line. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Let's meet the offense, Greg Robinson. Very, very talented.
What a man to set your offensive line with. Greg Robinson can do it all. Tremendous athleticism, great strength, just coming into his own.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
55, my guy, 55.
Hey, Delta.
Mayfield to throw it. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I liked his focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
Check 55 to Mike. Hey, we got to get the stop here, D. Check 31.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They run again on first down, Chubb. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down. So first possession, fourth and short. Field goal's no gimme from here. What do you think about going for it?
I'm not just thinking about it. I'm signaling, go for it. Let's get this, all okay. Right? Yeah, look, you're right. You know, the field goal's there, but it's not a chip shot. My big thing is opening drive, you're trying to establish momentum. Let's not stall it ourselves. Let's go get this first down and then continue on downfield trying to get a touchdown.
Like your confidence.
Yeah, why not? Let's go.
King. 26 miles.
Mayfield to throw for it on fourth. Forced out to his left. He may try and run for this. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
First down, and this one's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try. I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to...
Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Javon Hargrave, the D tackle, getting the sack.
Enough to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16, but they'll remain short of the marker, and it's fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. They've already gone for it and made it once on this opening drive. They're going to try it again on fourth down. Now Mayfield on fourth down. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. From the gun, Mayfield. And he's got this one complete to Callaway. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Only a yard of the completion. It's 2nd and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal.
Let's go, defense. Get out the field, defense.
They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Joe Hayden, the veteran, with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Landry, the intended target. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at the 20. First carry for James Conner. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up 2nd down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13. Now it's Roethlisberger. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. That one a gain of 20 and a 1st down. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. No score after 1 on EA Sports. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And yes, complete to the tight end, McDonald. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. On 2nd down, Conner looking for space. And they're well past midfield, just 1 yard or 2 shy of the 40.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
On 1st and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he's got his man, the tight end, McDonald. And this will leave him 1 yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down. That last catch short the marker by just 1 yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Play fake to Conner. Now Roethlisberger. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down. They tried the throw on 2nd down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with Conner. And he's going to get the 1st down as they bring him down at the 23.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
Right back to Conner here on 1st. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler 1st down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there is no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Here we go. 180. Mike. He's tired of me.
From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on 1st down. To Conner on the check down. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll bring up a 2nd down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
to throw again on second down. Roethlisberger, that is caught at the 7-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. James Washington there to make the grab as his guys are on the board first here tonight. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Extra point put through by Boswell. And it's now a 7-0 game. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be fielded at the 6. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Going right back to Beckham here, complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Fans, a reminder, I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime preview. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
You know, writing down your ad-libs.
If you print it, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Mayfield now rebounding nicely after the interception. He's hit 4 straight to start the drive. It's first down. Throwing. Mayfield, he's got Njoku, his big tight end. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2, now third down. You mentioned very early on the need to establish a running game for this young QB. They really haven't been able to do that, though, in the first half.
So that means what in halftime? Adjustments. Time, right? Figure out what they are, figure out the things that they really want to accomplish, and who to run behind. Which are your better blockers? Find those guys and get in that direction.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And this offense has converted twice already here in this first half on fourth down conversions. And here we go again. Now Mayfield dancing to his left. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Mayfield keeps it himself, and he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Baker Mayfield taking it in as they are now on the board here in the first half.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Greg Joseph on for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it was capped off by the quarterback sneak for 6. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And we're under a minute to go here in what's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together, could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
Set! Mike 30!
And got Mike number 53! Mike 53! Crunch time, defense.
Black and green!
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And the reception made by Dante Moncrief. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Got an open man, it's Washington. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. And this is Moncrief with a catch. Now the Steelers use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Ben to throw again. This one complete, right side to McDonald. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose, and this is picked up by the Browns. He's at the 40, past the 20. 10, 5, and he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. Big boy earning his lunch. That's what you call rumbling with the ball, Charles.
Big man with football. He wasn't just earning lunch, Brandon. He was earning dinner. He was
midnight snack.
Everything that you could possibly do, he did it on that play to pick up the ball and go.
Joseph on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Ready?
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Goddard.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now Roethlisberger, complete to Washington. Zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. James Washington, his second touchdown of the night, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just one play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
Boswell good with the extra point, and we are tied at 14. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple of extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game. We'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. To throw, Mayfield. That's complete. It's Charles. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Now left side on the swing pass. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17.
When you run a screen pass really well, you gotta like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Throwing on second and eight, Mayfield. This is the tight end, Njoku. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 27-yard line. First down. A run for Nick Chubb. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Push him back.
Strong run, but still wrangled before reaching the 20.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Bud Dupree in there to get him for a loss of three, and it will be fourth down. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a 1-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
time.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Ben leaves to counter on the draw. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Roethlisberger to throw. On the left side, it's McDonald. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. And he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Here's Roethlisberger. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
The Browns offense trotting back onto the field.
They get the crucial turnover, just huge, but now they've got the football deep in their own territory, and you got to be careful because if you give it right back, there goes your lead.
Have to be extremely happy with their defense. They received a gift. That takeaway, even though they're deep in their own territory, now they have the football. And you know there's always that alpha on defense, that grouchy guy. Forget what the coaches said. I'll guarantee you, he told the quarterback, we just took care of you. Now you take care of us.
A tight game like this, such a tough spot for the offense to be in. Even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line, they got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team with play calling as well. Not a lot of misdirection, not a lot of counters, not a lot of plays where you have extra ball handling. Get it right to the hands of your running back. Tell him to take care of the ball and try and move forward.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see.
Alert, 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 alert!
Field. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. It's caught by OBJ. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is second and less than a yard. On the ground, it's Chubb. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Now Chubb. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down.
They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. It's caught to Charles. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 31-yard line. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. A pretty good looking run there on first down. That'll go for 9 yards, just short of the line to gain. So fresh out of the 2 minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. They run it again with Chubb. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. And it is good. Oh, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way, but it does get over the bar. And they stretch the lead to 6. It's 20-14 now. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. Let's go. So Big Ben and the Steelers now down 20-14, just over a minute 40 to play. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That's good for 28 yards. He's back to throw. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it. But they've got to continue to move quickly. And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
This is where hustle and urgency come into play. I think you've got to get up there and spike it.
Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. It's caught by Moncrief. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They come up on a first and goal and most likely 4-down territory as they need a touchdown and the PAT for the lead. Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough trying to draw up a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run them a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from Pittsburgh.